And going back to the two models of research and factors that influence the health of minorities, one common denominator of these two models, this one and the one from the National Institute of Minority Health and Health Disparities, is the life course, the time variable, or the time element. And considering time, we can also consider events or factors that were not specifically verbalized or mentioned in the models that I presented, although there is some relation to adversity and socioeconomic factors. Nonetheless, these examples on the screen refer to examples of historical trauma and depression and other events, unfortunate events that have happened across the world that have been related to transgenerational impacts on health, especially on mental health, but also as a consequence, stress and cardiovascular disease or other chronic diseases. In addition to these events that happen to groups, to countries, to adults, and to children, there are other events that happen much earlier in life that could also have an impact, a long-term impact on health. And some of the examples that you are seeing on the screen relate to events that happen in utero, in maternal health, that have been linked to increased risk for chronic diseases later in life in the child. And related to time, in a sense, are genetics, genomics. This is an area that is still growing in terms of research and clinical practice for populations with health disparities and minority populations. While this field continues growing and expanding, one of the critical steps or the critical measures that could happen is the inclusion of minority populations in this type of studies and trying to identify genetic traits and genetic sequences, gene sequences that could be unique or only evaluated or identified or discovered in minority populations and not necessarily identify them in European populations and then try to identify them in other populations. Each population may have its own set of genetic traits that could be related to some of the diseases that we have talked about in the last few minutes. Data science, data banks, biobanks are also becoming very important sources for research. And like with genetics, the inclusion, the participation of minority populations, populations with health disparities in these efforts is really important. And because these are resources that would allow certain analysis that could not be done at the population level because costs or because there are circumstances that could not be fit for which they could not be feasible. And the study of data science and biobanks, big data, is ongoing and it's an area that we could embrace now. It's important that the quality of the data is high, to be high for the analysis to be good. The quality of the data are going to determine the quality of the analysis and the findings of the analysis. But also, these type of efforts need to account for full disclosure and communication with the participants. They need to meet high standards, ethical standards, and respect for these populations. So going back to the initial question, why is it important to study health disparities? It's to ensure that we are in the identifying and defining them well, reducing and eliminating them wherever we find them, and implementing and delivering the best healthcare practices for our patients and the populations we serve and represent. Why do we do research in health disparities? We can either document, we can explain, or we can develop strategies to reduce or eliminate them. If we want to do research to document, we need to ask some questions. Do we want to document a newly identified risk factor? Do we want to document a newly recognized disease manifestation? Do we document emerging disparities? Are we trying to retest and re-explore factors that have been redefined? Have there been any major population events like changes in policies, disasters, public health emergencies? And have there been population changes that we need to document? If we want to explain, are we going to explain mechanisms of disease, mechanisms of action that could be behavioral, that could be biological, that could be of any sort, even at the society level? Are we explaining clinical or population outcomes? Are we explaining changes or existing disparities based on change in policy, based on access or change in access to and utilization of health services? Are we explaining changes in disparities based on changes in healthcare systems, organization, and structure? What about the quality of healthcare? And what about the quality of life? If we are doing research to formulate strategies or test strategies to reduce or eliminate health disparities, are we talking about prevention? Are we talking about prenatal maternal health? We are talking about early life events. Are we talking about changes in policy? Are we talking about changes or interventions on social determinants of health, on environmental factors? What about healthcare needs? How do we assess them and how we intervene on them? Healthcare systems operation and organization. A physical infrastructure, the built environment, the social and community resources, and of course, interventions on sectors that are not strictly healthcare, but have such a huge influence. Whether we are doing research to document, to explain, or to strategize, all what we are doing is intended for us to make a difference in the lives of those that we serve and that we represent. When we talk about health disparities, we also hear the terms equality and equity. When we engage in research in health disparities, do we want to improve equality or do we want to improve equity? What is the difference? In this pictorial from the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation, equality is synonym of everyone receiving the same measure for the need they have, the same size for everyone. Would all the four persons on this picture move well and reach their destination if they receive the same measure? No, and it may cause some delays, it may cause some injuries, frustrations, and actually disparities. But equity is to feel the need accordingly. The measure is adapted and everyone moves with their ability and at their pace and reaches the destination safely. Think of disparities as opportunities to make a difference in your patients' lives, opportunities to translate research into better healthcare delivery and health outcomes for everyone. An opportunity to break with old paradigms. I invite you to navigate the National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities website, and especially take a look at the resources that we have posted there, including the Phoenix Social Determinants of Health Assessment Collection.